Coughing, sneezing, vigorous exercise can all be triggers for an embarrassing problem women of all ages feel really awkward talking about. But come to find out, USF Health is the leader in Florida when it comes to cutting-edge ways to help women who are suffering in silence from urinary incontinence.
Hi, Tiffany. It's Dr. Basali. It's good to see you.
OBGYN Dr. Renee Basali is part of a team of doctors at USF Health, treating patients with cutting-edge ways to manage urinary incontinence.
Okay, you're going to feel a little tap.
Like tibial nerve stimulation.
We're actually stimulating the nerve through the acupuncture needle.
Most patients don't even feel the needle go in.
Feel it now?
But they will start to feel a slight electrical current that stimulates the nerves.
All right, we'll see you in 30 minutes.
And this is just one of the many non-invasive ways doctors can now treat urinary incontinence.
So a lot of women are dealing with this problem. And
one out of three women are dealing with this problem in all age groups.
Really?
Yes.
From products you can buy over the counter.
It's used to block the urethra.
Okay.
So that it acts as a back support.
To small devices fitted by your doctors. There's even a pacemaker placed just under the skin.
So you're not sitting on it, you're really not laying on it, and you really can hardly feel it.
There are now so many ways to help women avoid suffering in silence.
Women don't understand the disease process, they don't seek care for it, they're embarrassed by it, so they're usually not coming into the offices to say, this is a problem for me, and I really want treatment.
Diet changes can help with urinary incontinence. It's a good idea to cut out alcohol, caffeine, tea, spicy foods, citrus foods, and talk to your doctor about certain medications that could trigger the problem. But most importantly, seek help, because new treatment options are available.